रेडियो खांची 90.4 एफएम पर प्रसारित किए जाने वाले विषय वस्तु का सारा क्रेडिट प्रस्तुतकर्ता को दिया जाता है। हमारा मकसद है समाज में ज्ञान एवं सकारात्मकता को आगे बढ़ाना।
वेलकम टू रेडियो खांची 90.4 एफएम, हम सबका रेडियो। दिस इज डॉक्टर सोनी कुमारी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, PPK कॉलेज बुंडू, अंडर रांची यूनिवर्सिटी रांची। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस on one of the most important topic of genetics, that is extra chromosomal inheritance in Mirabilis jalapa. For the students of UG SEM 3 paper CC7 under unit 2, the reference books are Cell and Molecular Biology by PK Gupta, Principles of Genetics by Gardiner, and Instant Notes in Genetics. Let's start the topic. As we all know, inheritance is a passing of traits from one generation to the next generation. The basic concept of Mendelian transmission genetics is phenotype is transmitted by nuclear gene located on the chromosome of both parents. Nuclear DNA is the very important and very nearly the universal genetic material, but the scientist indicated that extra nuclear or cytoplasmic DNA is also act as agents for hereditary transmission. This phenomenon is called extra chromosomal inheritance, which also defined as non-Mendelian inheritance. As we know that there are two cytoplasmic organelles which contain their own genetic material which getting inherited from parents to the offspring. These two organelles are mitochondria and chloroplast. Here I am discussing about plastid inheritance in Mirabilis jalapa. Plastid inheritance means inheritance of plastid characteristic due to plasma gene located in plastid. Plastid inheritance was first described by Carl Correns in 1908 in the four oak plant. Botanical name is Mirabilis jalapa. Plastid is a small cytoplasmic minute body which contain chlorophyll or green pigment produced by chloroplastid. Other pigments are white, colorless, produced by leucoplast which contain starch. Plastids are capable to inherit without inheritance of nuclear gene. At the time of reproduction, the male and female gametes fuse. Female reproductive cell is larger in size compared to the male cell due to more amount of cytoplasm and storage of food material. Large cytoplasm means more number of plastid within it. The newly formed zygote thus contain larger part of cytoplasm from female cell and contribute to the offspring phenotype. The phenomenon is referred as maternal inheritance. Inheritance is governed by chloroplasts, which are originated from proplastid. If the proplastid are normal, they will develop into normal chloroplast, and when proplastid are mutant, they will produce white chloroplast. In the plant Mirabilis jalapa, there are three types of branches. These are green, white, and variegated. White branches produce white leaf which contain leucoplast, whereas the green branches produce green leaves which contain chloroplast, and in variegated they have all three types of pigment. These are chloroplast, leucoplast, and chromoplast. Variegation means the presence of white or yellow spots of variable size on the green background of leaves. Due to inheritable defect, chloroplast of all cells and some cell are unable to synthesize the chlorophyll pigment. does it form the mosaic pattern of coloration on the leaves. Carl Correns made reciprocal crosses in all combination among the flowers produced on these three types of branches to understand the inheritance pattern. In the first cross, he observed that a cross occurred between green branch flower was used as female gamete or egg cell and either green, white or variegated as male gamete or pollen. All individuals in F1 were green, so all progeny appear will be green in color. In second cross, egg cell or female gamete from the flower on white branch, cytoplasm carry white plastid and male either green, white or variegated. All progeny in F1 generation were white in color. In the third cross, when egg cell or female gamete is in the form of the flower, green, white or variegated, the flower on variegated branch, cytoplasm carry green, white or variegated plastid and male is either green, white or variegated. The various proportion of green, white and variegated progeny is in F1 generation were appear. The crosses suggested that green leaf branches have normal chloroplast, white have mutant chloroplast and in variegated have a mixture of both normal and mutant chloroplast. Let's see the conclusion. Crosses indicates that leaf phenotype of the progeny is the same as that of the female parent. The phenotype of male parent did not contribute anything to the progeny. This phenomenon is referred to as uniparental transmission. The plastids are responsible for variation in the crosses of green, white and variegated leaves. Seed produced by green branches give rise only green plants. Seeds from white branches produce white seedling which did not survive due to lack of chlorophyll. But seeds from variegated branches could produce three type of progeny plant with green, white and variegated branches. So, from this simple expression, we can say that the color of leaves in the progeny is decided by the plastid which is present in the cytoplasm of female gamete. That's all about the topic. Thank you.